Start an idea or an album, and you think, oh, this time I do it completely different, you know? And then it's not different at all. It just sounds like you all along. It's nice to just somebody else brings in like the weird touch, something you can both consider, or you both consider beautiful. So it's called Juno as the synthesizer. Because I made already 3 albums before, it kind of felt natural to just work with more people than just myself. It's nice to just give something out of hand at some point and just have a different influence. I mean, I sample basically a lot, and so when it comes to work with people, it's the same for me as sampling. So I send somebody an idea and I don't have to edit it much, so you just say, oh, okay, great, let's put it on there, and that's it. I always wanted to have a red line in these records. You collect songs and then it grows on you as an idea, and then suddenly it fits together, basically. You know, we were thinking about, okay, who do we choose for artwork? And I totally loved his approach of taking photos, basically. Just like making it a bit more weird and collage-y kind of thing.
For the artwork, we wanted to do like something a bit more interesting. So the approach was to kind of have like one of Nico's individual images as like our center point. I think one thing it did, it really made me forget the time and everything around me, and it was like really helped me get this like tunnel vision and focus. It kind of like coded you in a way and like kind of muffled all the sounds and like just the world around you. And I feel like for that song, it kind of felt more like a feather that would like kind of slowly fall down and being like pushed around from the wind. So it had like a way more unexpected feeling to these like different kind of like highs and lows. Felt like it was very like a music collage in a way. It was like it sounded like all the elements were like kind of different recorded noises that were then like kind of put together, layered on top of each other. And that was like something that I thought of when I listened to the track for the first time, that it was like kind of like a music collage.
You always wait for kind of a drop or something, and then suddenly, bam, there we go. It makes all sense. First of all, it's like a more down-tempo song. And so you always have this laid back feeling. It's like a little bit shuffled all the time from the rhythmical part. Like, trance is a big, big, big part of my music anyway. So, I mean, I use African clappings and, you know, like sounds from there. And it's always a little bit, you know, you can lose yourself in there perfectly. I found something on a television record that, like a really small idea. So it's just sampling. Let that run in a loop. Going deeper and deeper, you know, taking layer by layer and layer. For this song, it starts a bit weird and then develops in the middle. And you always wait for that developing, so that Slow Your Bloom is also a little bit related to the arrangement of the song. I can't really put my finger, or like it takes me someplace. Pala started with this one. Basically, you search something, you record endless loop, and then you search out like little piece that you like. And like her entrance is really electronic. Also, the whole process of writing, you know, like big fat kick drums versus Impalas, try to make it more acoustic. You know, have shakers, take shakers, record shakers. That, you know, like everything should be more like natural and organic.
And the idea was there also that rather of like electronic and organic materials merging together, that they're like enhancing each other in like their own different ways, like an overwhelming feeling of being coded in like music or like art. And if you're in the right position and mindset when you're listening to it, it really kind of overwhelms you and kind of like rotates around you and like takes you in a way, something that you kind of like have to feel, or like and that was like also something where we draw like parallel lines between Nico's approach to music and my approach to artwork design, finding this like kind of sweet spot.
So I hope people can take it to places where I couldn't imagine.